Hello friends, today we are going to learn how to use this one fray hair and how to perform the one fray hair test for understanding or for getting the pain threshold, mostly in case of the animals. So this one fray hair test is mostly used to check the pain threshold. It comes under the mechanical allodynia. It will produces the sensation to the rat, and based on the response which are produced by the rats, we can calculate this percent threshold. Now, very first thing, what is one fray? Now, one fray hair test, it is a one fray hair, and this is a kit which containing a different 20 types of the hairs, and these hairs having the filament, this type of filament, and this filament is a nylon filament, it is plastic column, and it is calibrated with a specific type of the force and depending on the length, diameter and module of the material. So every filament, it is calibrated for a specific type of the force, and that filament will produce the stimuli or the pressure on the hind paw of the rat at that particular calibrated level. So this buckle, the force imparted by the column is fairly constant irrespective of the degree of buckling. Means once you take this filament and you push the filament towards perpendiculars towards the hind paw of the rat, irrespective of the degree of buckling, it will produces a constant force for which this particular filament is calibrated. So set of filaments are normally made of nylon hairs, all the same length but of various diameter, so as to provide a range of the forces. So typically from 0.008 gram force up to 300 gram force are available, which are used for in case of the animal. Now in case of animal, we always use the up and down methods, which is given by the Chaplin, and we always follow that Chaplin equation for calculating the percent threshold. Let's see how this experiment is carried out in the animal. For determination of pain threshold using one fray filament, frame is fabricated by considering the dimension or by reference with the dimension from Jubilant Biosciences, Bangalore. They have their setup of estimation of neuropathic pain. Now if you observed in this fabricated instrument, there is a rack and this is an acrylic chamber. It is a sixth chamber, and these six chambers are kept over a sieve, and below that there is a solid part. You can keep a paper or any other thing to collect the waste material as well as the husk which is filed down from the sieve. Now this acrylic chamber, they are partitioned by a black color solid acrylic material, and each chamber having a specific dimension so that animal can easily get comfort inside this chamber. If you observe this chamber, there is a sliding. By opening this sliding, you can keep here the animal. Likewise, at a time we can keep six animal into the chamber. These are the one fray filaments. These are 20 numbers. All these filaments, they are well calibrated against the force which they are produced. Now if you observe this 0.08, 0.02, 0.04, these are the target force in gram, whereas the 1.65, 2.36, these are the evaluator number of the one fray. Now how this one fray is open, I will show you the demonstration. You can take this anyone
rotate this, you will get such types of filament, and by using this filament you can evaluate the paw withdrawal threshold by the animal. Now we are keeping the animal into the chamber. For doing this experiment, one has to practice the animal to acquire the environment of the chamber, and then only it is possible to check the behavioral parameter. As these are the behavioral parameters, we have to keep the darkness. Now we have kept two animals and we are going to apply the force by each one of the filaments.
You have to start with first 2 gram force on filament. Now I am going to apply to the palm of the rat paw. As we have to apply for 10 seconds. If the animal is not withdrawing his paw, then you have to go for higher force. Here I am applying for repeat, I am repeating it. Yes, it is not withdrawing the paw.
Now in observation you can prepare such types of observation table, and when you apply the one free filaments on the hind paw of the rat, if it shows the response you can write as a X, and if it is not showing response then write down the O. You can always start with the 2 gram of the force, and how it can be carried out, see. You can take 2 gram force of the one free filaments and apply it perpendicular to the hind paw of the rat. If it is not showing the response, you can write down the O. Again, then it is a up and down method, so then you can go with the higher force and apply. If it is still not showing, you can write down the O. You can then take higher response, higher force, that is 6 gram pressure. You observe the response. Now it is up and down method, so once you are getting the response, again go with the lower force and try. If it is showing the response, now again you go with the lower force, you will observe this. So ultimately you are getting such types of the pattern, and maximum you can try for the nine steps, so you will get a pattern having the 9 characteristics. And this pattern then you can apply here. This is what a chart given by the chaplain, and it having the several pattern. Under this pattern you can observe your pattern, and by using this formula you can calculate the value of 50% gram threshold. So under this it is shown that xf is the value in log unit of final one free use. The final one free which you are using in your pattern, you can write down the value of that one free. K is the tabular value of the pattern. This is the K value. From this you can put the K value, and delta is the difference between stimuli, and this value is constant. So you can observe in this table where is your pattern. You can observe that by zooming this, you can observe your pattern is here, OOXX0, and its value is 1.22. You put the value in this formula and get 50% gram threshold. So likewise you can calculate calculate for your treatment, control and every group. So this is what the reference of the chaplain. If anyone interested, you can go through this paper. This paper explain everything very nicely. So thank you once again for listening this explanation.